I've been writing this letter to Lovisa. That's the girl that I rent this flat from. I really wish I had something more exciting to report. That's Lovisa's room. It's from the last century, but so is my mobile. I put this ad in a local paper. It hasn't helped much though. It's dead. The batteries are completely discharged and the battery charger is broken. Thank you.
kind of lonely, so it's nice of you to drop by. I spent most of it here, I'm afraid. What about you? Caught any cats lately? Come back anytime.
I think I need something to hang it on.
Hi, Carol. It's Katarina Fogel. I got something I'd like to talk to you about. I think I need your help. Can you please come over?
That was Katarina, Conrad's sister. Conrad was the man whose detective business I've taken over.
Thank you for coming on such short notice. I'm so happy that you haven't gone back to England. I'm sure you'll come up with something to do sooner or later. The reason I called you was, well, I don't really know if this is a case for you. But it really puzzles me. There's this woman at my work. As you know, I'm a teacher in Swedish literature at Djuraskolan. She's a history teacher, and she's a bit of a loner. I believe that I'm one of the few who has gotten close to her, whatever now close means. She hasn't showed up at work for the last 3 days without giving any notice, and she has behaved kind of strange lately. She's been late for class more than once, and she hasn't been home for the last 3 days either. I've been to her apartment several times in the last days. She told me that she doesn't have any relatives. She inherited her only sister a while ago, quite a large sum from what I understand. We've invited each other over for tea a couple of times, and she had me over for dinner once. We've also been to the theater 2 or 3 times. Oh, it's Anna Bergion, and she lives at Generalsgatan 6. I'm sure this will turn out to be nothing at all, but I really appreciate that you will look into it.
Business as usual, lots of important matters to be taken care of, but the yard must always be kept tidy. That's one of the top priorities. lots of salmon flying around today. Oh yeah, she lives here, in number 6. She hasn't been home for 3 nights, and she's never been away for one single night before. Well, I'm the caretaker here. It's part of my job to take care of my tenants in a proper manner. If something happens to one of them, I'm usually the first to know. I don't think I'd have been chosen for this job if it wasn't for my observational skills. It's all a matter of focusing on the right things and never letting anything get between you and your duties. There are over 50 applicants for this job and I had just the right qualities. They wanted someone who could speak English, for instance, since many foreigners live in Sweden nowadays. I wouldn't be holding this conversation with you if it wasn't for my skills in English.
Never mind. Maybe I should get him to sweep somewhere else.
Hands off my keys. They're tools of the trade.
Get 4 kroner back from the shops for a bottle like this. He might hear this.
You don't get anything for that bottle, I'm afraid.
Thank you. No way. I wouldn't have missed that. Okay, I'm just gonna wrap this up first.
Latex gloves. Whoops, it locked itself. It looks like something has been written here. I think I'll leave the door unlocked for now.
I'll make you a cup of tea from stinging nettles. I'm sure you'll like it. Yes, Anna showed it to me. Do you know anything about Axel von Fersen? He was a count that lived at the Lösta castle about 200 years ago. Anna seemed to have taken quite an interest in him. The painting shows his secret meeting place, where he's said to have met his mistresses. I think it's somewhere near the castle. It's just outside of town. You'll have no trouble finding it.
I don't think I should enter without permission. I don't think I should enter without permission.
Thank you.
The 20th of June, 1810. I don't think I should enter without permission. Animal burials.
In the pet cemetery. It's somewhere in the west side of town.
Thank you.
That doesn't look like a pet cemetery. That doesn't look like a pet cemetery.
Hello there. We met on St. John's graveyard. You asked a lot of questions. I've seen your ad. No, I don't. Every Tuesday, when there is something to bury, that is. No, this is the only one.
Every day is a lovely day. I wouldn't know about that. I'm the guide here. Well, it's just for the summer, and I just collect the tickets. There's lots of info about Axel von Fersen in the castle, but I can't let you in without a ticket. They are not for sale today, but you can win one on the castle quiz on the opposite building. You turn it on with the buttons inside the small metal door to the right of it.
I'm on this meditation program. I'm not supposed to move. I'm not supposed to move my lips either. Just walk in. The door is open. Take this and put it on your forehead. It will protect you from the ghosts.
Well, if you really think it's necessary.
Thank you.
It's too dark for me to go down there. A box of matches, which is a Swedish invention, by the way. So there's where that meeting place is. Thank you. A payslip from the prison and probation service.
Yes, Anna works extra as a history teacher at the prison.
Sorry, no.
This must have been written on Anna's typewriter.
Thank you.
Oh no.
I wasn't breastfed as a child. I've seen it on TV. I mean, programs about things like that are supposed to affect you in your adult life. Hasn't made any difference for me though.
Hi, Miss Bergeon. I just wanted you to know that I've swept the chimney now. I've left the key under the doormat.
Spain? What? The Animal Cemetery Committee. It looks exactly like the one I have. Thank you.
Of course I do. He was a prisoner. He used to help me here on Tuesdays. Something prisoners usually do. He escaped a couple of days ago. No. Well, maybe you mean the history teacher at the prison. Axel talked about her all the time. They had this common interest for history. I always suspected that he had something going on with her. He had permission to stay 1 hour after each class to talk with her about an essay on Axel von Fersen that he was working on. She even lent him her typewriter. Yes, that's some historical character he identified himself with. Murder. Go look it up in the papers. I'll tell you what. I actually believe that he was innocent.
No, I don't know what to do here. I don't think I'll go there just yet. That's Norrköping City Library. Yes, it's ugly. I shouldn't leave with a hoe. Thank you.
one of the largest in the country, and one of the few really big things in this town. Knock yourself out.
Thank you, but I'm already a member. The sect. I mean, you have that thing on your forehead. That's my husband. He died recently in a car accident. Oh, my husband was conducting his own personal investigation of him and the murder he was sentenced for. He was convinced of Axel's innocence. My husband's workroom is still untouched. You can look through it if you want to. You're welcome back, if it can be of any help.
I can't reach it. No, I'm not touching any of these computers. No, I'm not touching any of these computers. A battery charger. I can't reach it.
I don't think I should take anything from here.
Oh yes, it's right in the middle of Hageby. I dumped my old car there.
This music is really silly, but it's got a good beat.
Not.
What are you doing here? I get girls like you here often. You can have a look around, but that's where I draw the line. Look, I have a girlfriend. If I had batteries for my MP3 player, yes, I work better with music. Yeah, it's all mine. I've worked my way up. Well, no. Sounds like a composer to me. Ah, that's nothing. But don't come back.
It's open, but it seems to be stuck somehow. I'm afraid he might hear me when I'm doing this. I don't think they're charged yet.
I found this letter, addressed to my husband. It must have slid under the doormat for some reason. You may want to take a look at it. It's from his boss.
That's the day of the murder.
Thank you. I only needed one. I'll put it in right away.
He didn't turn that radio off. But never mind. A letter that hasn't been posted yet. AW, can that be Axel? It's locked. That's the wrong key. That's the wrong key. That's the wrong key. I must fix that wire before touching anything else here. I must fix that wire before touching anything else here. I must fix that wire before touching anything else here. No, I'm not going any further here. Thank you. I still can't trust that wire. I need to cut it first.
Yes? I don't work there anymore, and I'm not interested. I've got no recollection of anybody with that name.
I can't ask him that.
I've got no time for this. There's a documentary about line dance on television.
So Per the Gander had a key to Axel's apartment made. And he met with Lotte Anderson the day of the murder. The police were very interested in the letter from Lotte Anderson and the information I gave them about the key. Per the Gander was arrested immediately.
Remember that it is the only way to leave the country without a passport. I'm on my way home at the moment to take care of some final details. I made all necessary arrangements in Spain. See you in Spain.
Thank you.
Something tells me that you know the answer to that question already. Can you tell me who you are? You can't imagine how relieved that makes me feel. So, what you're saying is that another man will be prosecuted. Well, I've already come a long way, and I'm gonna finish my journey the way that we planned. I've no idea what you've done, but I cannot thank you enough.
Yes? What? I think we better take this from the beginning.
So I told her the whole story. Well, most of it.
So this means that Axel is free to go wherever he wants. Yes, we're supposed to meet there any day now, if it goes as planned. How can I ever thank you for this?
So Per Vaganda, the company's lawyer, had stolen money from the company. When Lotta was about to find out, he set up a meeting with her and poisoned her. He had a key to Axel's apartment made and planted some evidence there. Well, all is well that ends well, I suppose. Axel really seemed like a nice bloke, but you never know about people. I certainly hope that he didn't just use Anna to get out of jail and out of the country. I probably never know how they both end up. So I guess I just have to hope. Anyway, I hope you're doing fine, and I hope to see you soon. With love, Carol.